Hey everybody, it's Drogoth again, and I bring you game number two of this matchup between AJTLS as the pink Terran player in the upper right-hand corner of Zelnaga, and Green Ranger as the green Terran player in the lower left-hand corner. Again, this is game number two at the CCG tournament, Culture Crew Gaming in Standish, Maine. On that last battle, we did see a basic mirror matchup between these two guys, up until the point where Green Ranger actually opted for a command center to go for an expansion, where AJTLS focused on some Hellion Harass, going for the Infernal Pre-Igniter, and bringing a couple of Medivacs along for the ride to keep his Marine Ball tied up. Now, there was some really good micro by the Hellions. The battle was actually right out in front of Green Ranger's base. And the micro of the Hellions pulling them back, stim on the Marines. Green Ranger just couldn't handle that kind of pressure going into his base. And I would say that the command center was the difference in the build. Those the minerals used to build that command center could have been built on furthering structure that he built afterwards, or including maybe going tanks or some other type of build to push in on that. We do have the barracks coming down on both sides. Green Ranger just slightly ahead of AJTLS on that. Incomes are the same on both sides. However, Green Ranger does... Nope, they're going back and forth. So Green Ranger is just slightly ahead, as you saw, 13 and 13 going for both of those guys. Refinery is going down on both sides. Again, a mirror matchup, some pretty good mechanics going on both sides of these, except we do have a supply depot over blocking just part of the ramp, and a barracks right here, as opposed to the other side where we have the barracks blocking the ramp with a supply depot over here. This is mainly because when you have the ramp over here like this, the barracks cannot get an attachment without being in the top position, causing a weak point on the on any type of wall off that you do. Anyways, we have Green Ranger again just slightly ahead with the orbital command, getting down to supply depot too early enough. There we go. We have a Marine coming down. Here's where we actually deviate just a little bit. The supply depot is going down for Green Ranger, Marine coming down for AJTLS. So this Marine, the Marines will finish just different from each other. It's actually, they seem to have matched up again just slightly, and here we go to factory coming down by Green Ranger. So he has been going from the barracks right to the factory. Not sure if he's going to mimic some type of build that he saw earlier, or he may do some type of harassment trying to match AJTLS, beat him at his own game, perhaps. We will see as soon as this factory finishes. We have the second gas coming down for Green Ranger over on the left, but over on the right-hand side, do we see AJTLS going for that second gas? No second gas yet, and we do not have a tech lab or reactor coming down for Green Ranger, so it does not look like he will be coming out with any Hellion type of push. Factory is just about to finish, and the factory does finish. Refinery coming down for AJ just a little bit late. Just a little bit later than Green Ranger. And again, a fast armory coming down by Green Ranger. So it looks like we're going to have some type of Thor rush, as long as it's not scouted. We do have Hellions and a Starport coming down by AJTLS. So I'm sort of interested in seeing what's going to be happening. We do have, yes, it's a proxy Starport. So it looks like we might be having the fast Hellion into Banshee Harass if he pushes it over on the side. Tech Lab is coming down on the factory right now, so that fast Thor will be coming out once that Tech Lab has finished this. One of the Hellions did finish to add in with those Marines, and we do not, looking at the income tab really quick, Green Ranger is slightly ahead of everything, and here we go. Armory has finished. Are we saving up for Thor? Are we waiting for that mighty Thor? We do have a medevac coming down, and yes, we do have a Thor coming out, the fast Thor from Green Ranger. He is very good at this tactic. We do have this Hellion over here pushing away Green Ranger, so Green Ranger knows that there are already Hellions onto the board. There's that starport, so it actually looks like AJ is going to be going for the Hellion drops in the back. No added tech to that, and he still does not know what's happening in the back. However, we do have that Thor coming out to the front. Great move. We do not have a starport for any type of Hellion or any type of Thor drop at all, but with the mass of Marines to follow up behind it, it may be a very effective push. Here we go, the three Hellions moving in the front. They might be trying to push into the back. No wall over here except for these Marines. No stim for those Marines either. And there's that Thor. The Thor is sitting right out there. Second Thor coming out. Vikings coming out for AJTLS. And here we go. No, the Hellions move back. And we have four SCVs following that Thor, trying to corner trying to corner those, and that's not going to happen. We do have that other Thor coming out. It cannot be Chrono Boosters. Here we go, building that quick, pushing in quick right there. No. Drop it as, oh, Marine Drop into the base, and here we got the SCVs coming out. Great job by AGTLS, keeping everything moving out front. By the way, here come the Marines in the back. They do not have stim, so they cannot harass as much. SCVs coming back into play, and these two Thors have to stay in the back over here. Here we go with another Marine Drop, trying to drop in the back. No, not able to get in the drop. Hellions in the front, and there we go. Able to stop those Hellions that have been doing some great damage. Where is it? Here he is, way over in the corner. Medivac over in the corner. Scan going down. Scan seeing that we have the two Thors and several Marines over on the side moving out. Still looking on the back corner over here. It's really hard to see that pink dot. Take that Thor and drop it right here. Somehow get that Thor in the back there to get that Medivac down. And then some type of push out. What do we have on the backside over here? We do have a command center coming down and an additional barracks coming down. So the two barracks and the tank coming down. We do not have, any siege tech coming down. Again, this medevac sitting in the back over here, just dropping one of the Thors over here, might prove very useful. The starport is coming down, so it looks like we're going to be having some Vikings to push in over on that. But we do have, Siege Tech and Stim coming down. An additional Thor coming out with that starport, with a Stim Pack coming out onto it. Here we go, the Medivac moving in. And no, that Thor is not in place. We do have a Supply Depot coming down, not really going to affect anything. But these Thors slowly thumbling and bumbling. Will they be able to get that Medivac down? A couple of Marines do drop up. Three Marines do drop out, and those Marines do go down as these SCVs are gathering the resources very effectively, because that's what they do. And I sounded really stupid just saying that. Third Thor is out, so, and we still do not have a single Thor coming over, sitting over here to ping off that ship. Though we do have the Viking coming out. Viking does that bonus damage to the armored units, which is the medevac. Do we have some movement? Yes, we do have the expansion. Command center is moving out over there. We don't have Green Ranger. Look at that. We do have Cloaking Fields coming down with Banshee. Banshee coming out as Cloak is coming down. We do have AJ over here with a single SCV. And again, Green Ranger is just milling inside of his base, waiting for that medevac. Here comes the medevac. Yes, he's moving out, and he is getting attacked. Thor's coming in, and he will be dropping. Will not be able to get all of his units out. However, those Thors take him out. Four of the Marines did get out. One Marine did die inside the unit, and they will not be able to take anything right there. Green Ranger would do well to push out right now. We do have the tanks. Tanks did not fit. Yes, they did finish Siege. And it looks like Cloak has almost finished for these Banshees over here. How many Banshees are on the field? There's only a single Banshee on the field. Three Thors and a single Viking on that side. Two Marauders, 10 Marines. So a push might do well for the Thors. However, I'm not sure if these Siege tanks will cause some great damage to them. Let's look at the income really quick. Green Ranger is still ahead of AGTLS when it comes to the income. However, it does not look like it is. Here we go, Viking over there. And yes, we have siege tanks. Do we have siege tanks? Bunch of the Marines were taken out. Mass Marauders over here. Do they have concussive shells? They have stim. They do not have concussive shells. Here come the Thors coming in. Stim the Thors. One of the Thors goes down. A second Thor about to go down. There it goes. A third Thor is about to come down. And those Marauders just absolutely destroyed those three Thors as they walked in. Looking at the army difference, way too much of a difference at this point in time between Green Ranger and AJTLS. We still have these two Banshees over here. Did the Cloak finish? Yes, the Cloak finish and concussive shells is going down for Green Ranger. It looks like AJ is trying to build up a nice little defensive siege tank line, adding those Marauders. He does not have... let me see. Concussive shells is going down for AGTLS, so he will be slightly behind Green Ranger with those concussive shells. Looking at that, no, I think he might have actually canceled that. Wrong tech lab. I can't look with that little C symbol over on the side over here. Again, here we go. The pushing in. Nope, these Banshees are moving up as Cloak has finished for them, so they will be able to harass of some sort. We do not have any type of air defense, though, to get that Cloak. We do have a medevac sitting back here by Green Ranger. Not sure what he's going to be doing over here. Two SCVs doing absolutely nothing on the side over there. And here we go, another command center going over here. Lots of barracks coming down. And again, over on the side over here, we have two Banshees with Cloak pushing down on the left side. Again, no defense against the Cloaked unit, and yep, that's it. The Cloak does them. The single Viking, Cloaked units moving in, and there we go. A couple of Cloaked units inside the base. Nobody around. And that's it. Looking back at this, we do have Siege Tech going down for Green Ranger. Not going to be helping him against the Banshee play. These SCVs moving over onto the expansion. Do we have a turret? No, we do not have a turret. We do have a bunch of SCVs coming in and a Hellion. And the SCVs are just going to... Green Ranger calls GG. And that's it for that one. So are we doing best of fives on these or best of three?